மாஸ் கீழப்பாவூர்.
ஹாய், வெல்கம் டு மாஸ் கீழப்பாவூர் சேனல். ஐ எம் டாக்டர் அருணா சண்முகவே. வித் அ கோட், லெட் அஸ் ஸ்டார்ட் த வீடியோ. ரிவர்ஸ் நெவர் கோ ரிவர்ஸ், ஸோ ட்ரை டு லிவ் லைக் அ ரிவர். ஃபர்கெட் யுவர் பாஸ்ட் அண்ட் ஃபோக்கஸ் ஆன் யுவர் ஃபியூச்சர். ஆல்வேஸ் பி பாசிட்டிவ், ரைட்? ஓகே. வாட் ஆர் த மசில்ஸ் ஆஃப் மாஸ்டிகேஷன்? The muscles which are helpful for chewing are the masticatory muscles. They are lateral pterygoid, medial pterygoid, temporalis and masseter. Let us see the lateral pterygoid in detail. Look at the picture. This is the lateral pterygoid muscle. In this picture, you can appreciate both the lateral pterygoid muscle and the medial pterygoid muscle. Before learning any muscle, you should know the bones related to its origin and insertion. The lateral pterygoid muscle arises from the sphenoid bone. So we should recollect the sphenoid bone, and the same muscle is getting inserted to the ramus of mandible. We should recollect the ramus of mandible also. And here you observe the lateral pterygoid plate. It has got a lateral surface and a medial surface. When you trace it straight up, you get infratemporal surface of the greater wing of sphenoid. So watch the next picture. The origin of lateral pterygoid. It has got two heads, upper and lower head. The upper head of the lateral pterygoid muscle arises from infratemporal surface and infratemporal crest of the greater wing of sphenoid. The lower head of lateral pterygoid muscle arises from lateral surface of lateral pterygoid plate. The muscle is horizontally placed. The lower fibers run posterolaterally and reaches the condyle of the mandible. Let us see the insertion of lateral pterygoid. Before going to that, observe the ramus of mandible. The ramus of mandible has got two surfaces. One is lateral, the other one is medial, and two processes: coronoid process anteriorly and condylar process posteriorly. Observe the muscles inserted to the ramus. All the muscles of mastication, that is the lateral and medial pterygoids, masseter, temporalis, are getting inserted to the ramus of mandible. Look at the picture. The masseter in the lateral surface and medial pterygoid in the medial surface of the ramus below and behind the mandibular foramen are getting inserted. And one muscle to each process, that is temporalis to the coronoid process, lateral pterygoid to the condylar process, are getting inserted. Let us concentrate the insertion of lateral pterygoid muscle. The lateral pterygoid muscle is getting inserted to the pterygoid fovea, the condyle of mandible, and to the articular disc of temporomandibular joint, and also to the capsule of the temporomandibular joint. Relations of the lateral pterygoid muscle, you can look at the picture. From the upper border of the lateral pterygoid muscle, the deep temporal nerves and vessels, also mesenteric nerve and vessels, are emerging out. Same way, from the lower border of the lateral pterygoid, the lingual nerve and inferior alveolar nerves are emerging. Between the two heads of lateral pterygoid, two structures are passing. One is the maxillary artery, the other one is long buccal nerve. Observe the maxillary artery here. The maxillary artery has got three parts, and the first part of the maxillary artery arises from the external carotid artery till the artery reaches the lower border of lower head of lateral pterygoid muscle. When the artery lies over the lower head, it is the second part. The third part of the maxillary artery dips between the two heads of the lateral pterygoid muscle. Here you can observe the two heads of lateral pterygoid taking origin from the infratemporal surface and crest of the greater wing as well lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate and the insertion to the pterygoid fovea. Observe the two nerves emerging from the lower border, the lingual nerve anteriorly and the inferior alveolar nerve posteriorly. Here in this picture you can see the maxillary artery dipping between the two heads of lateral pterygoid muscle. The superficial relations of lateral pterygoid are masseter, ramus of mandible, tendon of temporalis and maxillary artery. The deep relations are mandibular nerve, middle meningeal artery, sphenomandibular ligament and deep head of medial pterygoid muscle. In this picture you can observe the maxillary artery having three parts. Remember, all the muscles of mastication are getting their supply from the second part of the maxillary artery. So lateral pterygoid muscle is getting blood supply from the second part of the maxillary artery. The pterygoid plexus of veins surrounds the lateral pterygoid muscle and facilitates venous drainage, and this muscle, since it facilitates the venous drainage, it is called as peripheral heart. The anterior division of mandibular nerve is going to supply the lateral pterygoid muscle. The function of the muscle, that is, this is the only depressor of mandible opening the mouth, and it helps in protrusion. Both the lateral and medial pterygoid muscles act alternatively in side to side movement. With a quote, let us complete the session. Which one do you like, hard work or smart work? Let me say, hard work in a smart way, wholeheartedly, brings you success. Thank you for watching.